figure shows the articulated robot. An articulated robot is the opposite of the Cartesian robot in the sense that all three of all major axes are revolute rather than prismatic. Means Cartesian coordinate robot having three prismatic axes or three prismatic joints, and articulated robot having three revolute joint. Here the first revolute joint swing the robot back and forth about vertical base axis. This is the vertical base axis, and the first revolute joint swing or rotate the robot arm back and forth. The second joint pitches. Okay, second joint pitches. This is the second joint. Second joint pitches robot arm up and down. Okay, so the second joint pitches arm up and down about horizontal axis. This is the horizontal axis, and second joint pitches the robot arm up and down about horizontal axis. And third joint, this is the third joint, gives wrist motion, pitching wrist motion about horizontal axis. So all degrees of freedom of each and every joint, first joint, second joint and third joint, with revolute or rotary motion, that's why resulting configuration is triple R, rotation, rotation, rotation. First R for the shoulder joint, second R for the elbow joint, and third R for the wrist joint. Means shoulder joint having rotary motion, then elbow joint having rotary motion, and wrist joint having rotary motion. So this is the simply configuration of articulated robot. Articulated robot is nothing but jointed arm robot. Or work volume or work envelope, work volume or work envelope generated by articulated robot or jointed arm robot, it's simply sphere. Then next robot or next classification point according to work envelope is the SCARA robot. So first of all, SCARA stands for S-C-A-R-A. SCARA stands for Selective Compilance. SCARA stands for Selective Compilance Assembly Robot Arm. Okay, this is the long form of SCARA, Selective Compilance Assembly Robot Arm. So SCARA robot used for assembly purpose. Okay, so this is the simply construction of SCARA robot. This is the particularly image of SCARA robot and work volume of SCARA robot. So SCARA robot shoulder and elbow rotations are vertical. Okay, so this is the shoulder joint, means joint axis of SCARA robot having vertical direction. First vertical direction, second vertical direction, third vertical direction. Means SCARA robot shoulder and elbow rotations are vertical. This robot also having the revolute joint and one prismatic joint. Means two revolute joint and one prismatic joint. That's why the configuration or resulting configuration is RRP. Means two revolute joint and one prismatic joint. This is the first revolute joint, this is the second revolute joint, and third prismatic joint. Means prismatic means linear motion between two links. Then the first revolute joint, this is the first revolute joint, the first revolute joint rotates the arm back and forth, rotates the arm back and forth about the vertical base axis, about the vertical base axis. And the second revolute joint rotates the arm back and forth about vertical axis. Okay, means rotation of both rotary axis or both joints having vertical axis. And third joint, this is the third joint, third prismatic joint, means wrist joint. The third joint is the prismatic joint which slides the wrist up and down. Okay, that's why the motion configuration or resulting configuration R for rotary, R for rotary and P for prismatic. That's why resulting configuration of SCARA robot is RRP, rotary, rotary and prismatic. So this is the simply resulting configuration or motion configuration of SCARA robot. So this is the another image or exactly view of SCARA robot. So it in that SCARA robot, it is the combination of an articulated arm and the cylindrical robot. The work envelope of SCARA robot, this is the work envelope. The work envelope of the SCARA robot is simply cylinder. Means work envelope generated by SCARA robot is simply cylinder. So what are the different characteristics of SCARA robot? So first characteristics, a large workspace, then fast cycle time, then excellent repeatability, good payload capacity as compared to other robots. SCARA robot having good payload capacity, then excellent repeatability due to vertical axis. Quick response or excellent repeatability, and fifth, sophisticated motion control. Means motion control of SCARA robot is sophisticated. Then application of SCARA robot. So particularly SCARA robot are used for assembly operation, then pick and place operation, then handling machine tool application or application of sealing purpose, sealing and packaging purpose. So this is the all description regarding the SCARA robot. Then next is different joints used in robot. So first of all, definition of joint, or what is particular meaning of joint. Joint is the lower pair formed between two links. Okay, so joint is nothing but lower pair formed between two links. The motion in the joints can be translatory, linear, sliding or rotary. So there are two important joints, prismatic joint and revolute joint. So first, cylindrical pair or cylindrical joint. So this is the figure of cylindrical pair. So cylindrical pair having one sliding joint or one rotary joint. Okay, means one sliding joint and one rotary joint, and degrees of freedom two, because one is for rotary and another is for reciprocating or sliding. Then prismatic pair. So this is the example of prismatic pair. Okay, so prismatic pair having only one sliding motion, that's why degrees of freedom one. Then revolute pair having one rotary motion, degrees of freedom one. Okay, it's only one rotary pair. Then screw pair having one rotary, one translatory motion. Okay, that's why each and every joint having one degrees of freedom, one for rotary, one for translatory. That's why degrees of freedom of screw joint is equal to 2. Then planar pin. So this is the planar pair. Planar pair having one rotary and two translatory motion. That's why degrees of freedom is equal to 3. Means 1 degree of freedom for one rotary joint and 2 degrees of freedom for two translatory motions. Means planar pair or planar joint having 3 degrees of freedom. And last pair or last joint is the spherical pair. Spherical pair having 3 rotary motions. This is the spherical pair. Spherical pair having 3 rotary motion, that's why degrees of freedom for spherical joint, this is the spherical joint, is equal to 3, means 3 rotary motion, rotary motion about vertical axis, horizontal axis and longitudinal axis. That's why spherical pair or spherical joints having 3 degrees of freedom. So particularly joint is a lower pair formed between two lines, or joint is the lower pair formed between two links, and the motion in the joint can be translatory, sliding or linear or rotational. So this is the description regarding the joints used in robot. So SCARA robot having 3 different joints, means shoulder joint, elbow joint and wrist joint. So shoulder joint having rotary motion or rotary motion about vertical axis, then elbow joint having again rotary motion about vertical axis, and third joint, wrist joint, having prismatic motion about their longitudinal axis. So in this way you can directly calculate motion configuration as well as the exactly configuration of each and every robot involving robotics, means SCARA robot, articulated robot, jointed arm robot and all robots.